Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I'm going to show you how to use your Sony camera's in-camera proxy feature to take your footage from playing back like this in your editor, slow and stuttery because the footage is so high quality that your computer cannot keep up with it, to this incredibly smoothly playing back footage that you can scrub through like a hot knife cutting through butter. And this is a huge deal because by creating proxies in camera, this means that you will never have to waste time and slow down your workflow creating proxies in post. Here's how I do it. Let's start by talking about how to enable this feature. If you're on a newer Sony camera like the a7S III, a7 IV, a1, or any of the newer cameras that have the newer menu system, you're going to want to enable this feature by going to the red camera menu and selecting proxies. Here you will notice that you have two options. You can either select XAVC-S proxies, which are going to be recorded at 720p resolution, or XAVC-HS proxies that are going to be recorded in 1080p resolution. Considering that these are just proxy files, though, that you're going to be using to speed up your editing, and you want them to be as fast as possible, I would not go with XAVC-HS and instead choose XAVC-S, because this is going to offer you the smallest file size, resolution, and bitrate, which means that your footage will play back as smoothly as possible when editing. Alternatively now, if you have an earlier Sony camera, like the a7 III, a6600, etc., with the older style of menu, you can still use proxies with these cameras by navigating to the movie menu and turning proxies on. You don't have any other settings to change to do this. Next, we need to talk about which memory card you should use, with the biggest factor being the speed of the memory card. Because if you don't have a fast enough memory card, you are not going to be able to use proxies with certain frame rates. To save you time, I've created a mega chart of all of the frame rates and resolutions and memory card speeds that I've tested, and that is in a nice little PDF cheat sheet that you can download for free down in the video description if you want to figure out if your memory cards are going to work for making proxies. To summarize the in-depth cheat sheet though, I would really recommend purchasing SD cards that have a speed of at least V60, because these are going to be the best bang for your buck in terms of the amount of proxies they support for the price. If you buy slower V30 memory cards, they're only going to support recording proxies in 4K at 24 frames per second, and while they will support recording in 4K 60, it is only going to be at a maximum of 8-bit, not 10-bit. And considering I know that a lot of filmmakers want to record with 4K 60 in 10-bit, this is why I recommend faster V60 or V90 cards. Lastly, in regards to memory cards, there is one more limitation that we need to talk about, and that is the sad news that unfortunately it is impossible to create proxies in camera while recording at 120 frames per second, either in 4K or even 1080p. Even if you buy the fastest memory cards that you can get for your camera, which for the a7S III and a7 IV, a1, etc. are CF Express Type A memory cards, the camera will still not allow you to record proxies in camera while shooting at 120fps. I wish it were possible, but if I was to guess, this looks like more of a heat issue, where the camera would be pushed too hard if it's trying to record two separate videos, both at 120 frames per second. It would probably just melt the camera. So, unfortunately, if you are someone that loves to record at 120 frames per second, you will instead need to create proxies in post using your editing software. The good news is that I have a tutorial to show you how to do that in Adobe Premiere Pro if you want to check it out. I'll link to that video in the corner and down in the video description. Now, let's shift gears and talk about how to edit with these proxies that you have recorded in camera. If you're using Adobe Premiere Pro like me, here's how to use these proxies in your software and save you a ton of time. First, you're going to want to connect your memory card to your computer, and then you're going to want to make sure that you copy the entire file structure from the memory card. If you're somebody that usually just copies the video files, you're going to be upset because your proxies are not going to be there. So I'd recommend copying everything like I've done here. Next, open up Premiere Pro and import your full resolution video clips. I've imported some here onto the timeline too for the sake of this example. It's finally time to get those proxies. So go back to the folder that has all of your footage in it and go back to the M4 root folder and go to the subfolder. And here, look, there's more video clips. These are all of your proxy video files. And you have one more thing to do. You need to change the title of these video clips so Premiere Pro will automatically import them correctly. If you do not do this step, you are going to need to manually link every single proxy file that you've recorded to the native video files. And this is going to be a huge pain and take you a ton of time. To make these proxies work in Premiere, you need to delete these last three characters from the file name, in this case, this S03, and you need to replace them with the text underscore proxy in all caps. This is how Premiere natively handles proxies and will guarantee that your proxies work flawlessly with your full resolution video files. Now, of course, I only have four video clips here, so I could rename them fairly quickly. But if you have a lot of video clips, say you're filming a wedding and you have hundreds of video clips, renaming them individually would be a huge pain. So if you are on Windows, I would recommend that you use a free piece of software called Bulk Rename Utility to rename your files. And if you're on Mac, I will link down in the description to an article showing you how to bulk rename your files in Mac OS. I'm going to press Control Z now to bring this video title back to match all the other video titles so I can use the bulk rename utility. I'm going to go down here and open up bulk rename utility. Ooh, check this out. This looks complicated. Don't worry, it's actually really easy. First, up here on the left, you're going to want to navigate through this folder tree down to where your proxy files are kept. In this case, we got to go down here to M4root. Go to sub, and here are the proxy files. Then I'm gonna press Control A to select all of these proxy files, and we're gonna go down here to this remove section, and we're going to say we want to remove the last in. Click, 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 and then you're gonna notice up here that under new name, you'll see that the last three numbers and letters have been removed. Then we're going to go over here to add, and we're gonna go down to suffix, and we're gonna type underscore capital PROXY. And you'll see here that this is what it is saying the new name is going to be. Click rename. It's going to say, are you sure? Yes, press OK. Press OK again. And looking back at this folder, look, we've just renamed all of this text to now have underscore proxy at the end. This is going to save you so much time. Lastly, all you need to do is go back into Premiere and go back to the project panel. I'm going to select the first clip, hold down shift, select the last clip so they are all selected. And then I'm going to right click on these clips. Go to Proxy, Attach Proxies. That is going to open up this Attach Proxies dialog box. And then make sure that Relink Others Automatically is selected. Click Attach. And that's going to open up this window here that has all of your native video files, but we want the proxies. So let's go down here to the subfolder. And you'll see here it says it wants us to attach proxies to C3186. So we're going to select C3186 underscore proxy. Press OK. And Premiere is going to automatically detect all of the other proxy files and automatically attach them to the native files. You can toggle your proxies off and on by using this toggle proxies button. If you do not see this button though, hit this plus icon over here and then find the proxies icon and drag it down to right here and then you can use it. Press OK, scrub through here. Here's the native file without the proxies. You can see how slow this is. And then let's turn on the proxies. Check it out. Look how smooth that is. It's like, what? You want to look at some tree footage? We got tree footage. It's so smooth. Oh my gosh, I love it. Lastly, I would be aware that whenever you are ready to color grade your clips, I would always recommend using the full resolution version of your files to do that. So I would then turn off your proxies whenever you want to color grade. Speaking of color grading, if you want to get incredible colors with your Sony footage or with any other camera footage for that matter, I've created a set of color presets called Who Is Matt LUTs that are guaranteed to get you amazing looking colors in your videos, regardless of which picture profile you use. I will link to Who Is Matt LUTs down below. And that's how you use in-camera proxies with your Sony camera. I really hope this video has been helpful to you and is going to save you a ton of time when editing your videos. Please keep in mind that that proxy file cheat sheet is linked down below if you want to save time and make sure that your memory cards will properly work with your camera. Lastly, I want to help you out even more with your editing. So I've created another free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro. And this guide is going to walk you through some of the most advanced techniques that I have learned to edit videos that took me years to learn. So if you are just getting started, or even if you've been filming and editing videos for a while, I'm betting there's something in there that will help you. You can download that guide for free down in the video description. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.